to... I believe I would rather write it or whisper it to you and let you decide for yourself whether you want it talked out or not.
That will answer, said Luigi. Write it.
Wilson wrote something on a slip of paper and handed it to Luigi, who read it to himself and said to Tom,
Unfold your slip and read it, Mr. Driscoll.
Tom said,
It was prophesied that I would kill a man. It came true before the year was out.
Tom added, Great Scott! Luigi handed Wilson's paper to Tom and said, Now read this one. Tom read,
You have killed someone, but whether man, woman, or child, I do not make it out.
Caesar's ghost, commented Tom with astonishment. It beats anything that was ever heard of. Why, a man's own hand is his deadliest enemy. Just think of that. A man's own hand keeps a record of the deepest and fatalest secrets of his life, and is treacherously ready to expose himself to any black magic stranger that comes along.
But what do you let a person look at your hand for, with that awful thing printed on it?
Oh, said Luigi reposefully, I don't mind it. I killed the man for good reasons, and I don't regret it.
What were the reasons?
Well, he needed killing.
I'll tell you why he did it, since he won't say himself, said Angelo warmly. He did it to save my life. That's what he did it for. So it was a noble act, and not a thing to be hid in the dark.
So it was, said Wilson. To do such a thing to save a brother's life is a great and fine action.
Now come, said Luigi. It is very pleasant to hear you say these things, but for unselfishness, or heroism, or magnanimity, the circumstances won't stand scrutiny. You overlook one detail. Suppose I hadn't saved Angelo's life, what would have become of mine? If I had let the man kill him, wouldn't he have killed me, too? I saved my own life, you see.